Good afternoon. Welcome to everyone, including our new fans of the Open Gate Show. Today, October 30th, 2020, it's here at last when all questions will be answered in the 100th running of the Jamaica Derby. It pays to listen to the Open Gate Show.
Hello, racing fan. This is Emilio Bimbo Rodriguez. Listen to the Open Gate Show with Colin Blair, giving you the latest tips and reviews on the horses. Big up the number one show.
Greetings, everyone. This is George Osang, listening to Open Gate Show. Number one, take a listen.
Race one, name in honor of Winston Griffiths OD. He rode 11 Derby winners and was inducted into the Guinness Book of World Records for most classic wins in 1992. This race goes 6.5 furlongs or 1300 meters. 13 starters is for Nidabit trios only. It's a made special weight race. Number one, Lady Bastipur showed value when first time Lasix was applied, but weakened after showing early speed for third place, 9 lengths away from War of the Roses and Gambler. Going extra furlong less tomorrow, and I look better at exercise, but we'll be facing tougher opponents now. Number two, Purposely. If breaking better from the gates, could reward those that place the high five with a low exotic placing at good odds. Number four, Big Mama. Not doing much of exercise and maybe using the races to get fitter. This one has been giving Wayne Acosta some problems to sort out. Tongue tie is off for a second time in all her 8 career starts. Anthony Thomas, he against rides. Number five, No Identity, looking a bit better since last race, 8 days ago, and gets the figure it on after 2 career starts. No Identity has a chance to be a factor in the top three. Number six, It Is Now will make her 10 career starts tomorrow. Mike Marlowe's barn is revived. Maybe this filly, It Is Now for her. Well, let's see what use she has. Number seven, Color Me Tan, ran evenly 9 days ago against a similar set, going 0.5 furlongs more, and gets a slight pull in the scales, and surely expected to be part of the outcome again. Number eight, Crashes de Levine, was known to be closing in the last furlong against Lesser. Number nine, Battle Dancer, well-bred grey colt, who has been stepped up in training, although not too extensive, gets first time Lasix and tongue tie after 2 career starts and looking very sharp this week on the exercise track. Number 10, Expeditious, came off a 7-month respite and broke slowly from the gates to finish 18 and 10th. But should benefit from that race and could get a low exotic spot. Number 12, Zabatoni. He comes back after that below expected run when out of form stablemate Jacaris ran and won quite easily. He's paper light and against tougher here. I must emphasize, he ran okay with heavier weight against similar company as this. So it's interesting to see how Zabatoni runs. One of these, number 7, Color Me Tan, number 5, No Identity, number 9, Battle Dancer, number 1, Lady Bastipur, number 12, Zabatoni. I should enlighten race fans that there has been an increase in purse money. So you'll have some horses that will step a notch down to compete for that coveted purse increase reward. So you need to bear that in mind. We go to race 2, 4 is an up. For none of the four, 8 starts as they go a mile or 1600 meters. It's named in honor of Seeking My Dreams. Of course, you all know Seeking My Dreams in 2015 won the Derby. Omar Walker was the rider, Derek Smith, OD, owner, Wayne Acosta, the trainer. quite a remarkable horse, and he's currently at stud. Number one, China Max, well-bred colt, was given away for 350,000 in November last season, has improved since that, and has really done well since the COVID restart, and it really showed its true value, because it's breeding, it's My Lucky Day by a winner out of Skip Away. That is a well-bred horse, and they run on any surface. Scored two quick wins over a suited distance going two turns. Here at a mile should still be a force to try and make this three in a row. Number two, Top Shelf, stretching out to an unsuited distance. Number three, Bloodstone and Tears, stepping up a grade to earn some feed money, hopefully. Number four, Extruder, fairly consistent colt who has put on some weight and some sheen as well since last race. Even with 57 kilos, he has a fair chance where he is he's expected to set the pace. Number five, Casual Peach, has been a different filly since the Cardenas held her off the pace to show a good turn of foot to score two quick victories and now looking for a hat-trick of wins up in class. Number six, Purple Rain, been in his grade since early August, training okay, and one who has to be given a technical ride to do well. Anthony Thomas surely will do same. Number seven, Tricky One, flatters to deceive, but capable of fighting this out. Could have run better on last. His half-brother, one of a kind, runs later in the Derby. Number eight, Inspired Miracle, another who skipped class to earn something out of this small field. Any one of these. Number one, China Max. Number seven, Tricky One. Number four, Extruder. Number six, Purple Rain. In that order. We move on to race three, named in honor of Ransom Man, 2006 Derby winner. Ransom Man was ridden then by visiting Trinidad and jockey Brian Harding, owner Darrington Ferguson, trainer Egerton Fullerton. Quite a good feat for a small trainer there. This race goes 5.5 furlongs or 1,100 meters. 11 starters is for trails and up. Optional claiming 400 to 450,000 with 5 year-olds who have never won 4 races in their career. Number 2, Super Bold, won 5 of his last 7 starts with a 2nd and a 3rd place finish in the other 2. Claimed by a barn who does well with these and goes for their go-to rider in Anthony Thomas. 57 kilos, allowing number 7, KJ Express, maybe will be too much weight to allow Super Bowl's nemesis. Number 3, Locomotive, has enough speed to be a factor for a placing on the board. Number 4, Capone. Last two were okay, but he has to come in similar mood to have a say for a top 4 slot. Number 5, Cartel, have had 2 quick races out the straight course, back within 7 days, but on the round with Dane Nelson. Let's see if the back-to-back races will cause any effects on this horse, who is trying to give Richard Phillips, veteran trainer, a long overdue win. Number 7, KJ Express, nicely handicapped to win here. He's so better off at the scales now against number 2, Super Bowl, for 1. And that alone should make KJ Express a dangerous contender in this race. Number 8, Okahumko, ran with most of these on occasions, but was never a factor. But chances are, could be part of the, well, maybe can get a slot in the lowest part of your exotics. Number 10, Nuclear Dandada, recently changed stables 2 weeks ago and getting 57 kilos against strong competition. Number 11, Polly B, can't see him winning after last week's poor display with strong support on the board at 5-2. Didn't come back to the winner's enclosure looking all that well. So within just a week, I can't see it. Anyway, number 7, KJ Express. Number 2, Super Bold. Number 4, Capone. Number 5, Cartel. Number 3, Locomotive. In that order, we go to race 4. It's the SVRL Sprint Trophy. going 6 furlongs or 1,200 meters for native trios only. It's a stakes race, grade 3. 10 starters. I would expect most hair to be penciled for this race due to the lucrative purse of $1.5 million. Number one, Alexis Lodge, youthful filly who should be competitive in the end due to her closing ability. Number three, Loose Ball, ran well last week. When closing fastest of all, approaching the winning post against stable companion Who Shot the Sheriff. Number seven here, Basilicus, and number 10, Glock. Rinda Costa, go-to rider, Antenna Thomas, is on this time. Number five, England Rose, waned off since those two back-to-back victories in impressive style in June, July. That was when she broke her maiden and then went to non-winners of two. Had four subsequent starts, which seemed far from her real potential. Working well as usual and lost a little bit of weight since that 58 and 45 workout on October the 7th. The Open Gate Show didn't like her physicality there on after that workout. But yesterday and this morning, she looked fantastic. She was skipping past the winning post with Anthony Thomas. And when she turned around to go into her canter, she looked immaculate. Well, she had nothing to complain about, especially at this handicap. So we'll see. Number six, Adore Brilliance, going places filly, whose connections seemingly realize she is best on for now. Won in a fast time at 6.5 furlongs, 119 flat, pulling away. Back 2 weeks to face some quality trios, has got to improve, of which she has scope to. Number seven, Basilicus. I would imagine that some racing fans remember this was a horse that was won in a raffle by a punter. And really, this horse really did well. The punter, Basil Gordon rather. Basilicus would have won if not losing her ridden at the furlong point. And last, yet still managed to hold second in front of number three, Loose Ball, and number 10, Glock. She has improved and will be more focused now than last, but we'll have to fight this out, especially at 6 furlongs. Number 9, Run With Me, stablemate of Basilicus, came off a month break and ran even against the top ones here. At finishing 5th and 6th, gets a pull in the scales and should benefit from that run at last, and really merit some serious consideration, seeing that he had betted Glock. Number three, Loose Ball, in his earlier career. Really looked good this morning when cantering. Number 10, Glock, run wide all the way last week against five horses here who were in that race. The race that won by Da Costa, who shot the sheriff. Even though running wide and losing valuable length, still managed to be 1.5 length third. Glock will be focused for this more than that last run. I'm taking number 9, Run With Me, to upset number 10, Glock, and number 5, England Rose. Number 1, Alexis Lodge, will run good. Number 7, Basilicus, should have a chance to be there, as well as number 6, Adoring Brilliance. Race 5, named in honor of 2007th Derby winner, the Bomber. The Bomber was owned by Rosie Dahl, trained by Patrick Lynch, Winston Griffiths. He rode him then. This race has attracted 14 starters. They go 5 furlongs straight or 1,000 meters straight. Number 1, Get Storm, drawn on the inside when coming off a 2-month break to run an even 5th place gets a similar jaw, but very light. Now, I get over a trip that she adores, could get in your lower exotics at very attractive odds. Number two, dream of mine. We'll be making her 9th tour start, showing mediocre display all on the round course. This is the first time she'll be out the 5 furlong straight course tomorrow. Looking more focused than ever. Let's see why Omar Walker stick with this one. Number seven, Love Me Tender. I love that name, but that's all I can see in this filly. All right, number eight, Uncle Bally. Another hair coming off a short respite, but I was far from impressed how she looked coming into that race 14 days ago. Has shown value in July and August. First, after running 5 days, the first time this horse has run, we all thought that, you know, he would have been a much better animal, but horses at times have issues. On last, when he ran, didn't like how he came back, but his trainer is capable to improve him off that run. Let's see, coming out the straight for the first time, what Uncle Bally will do. Number nine, Unpredictable. Very small filly who is coming along slowly on exercise. While I mention these horses, you can take note, because in time they will pop up in you, and at least you remember the Open Gate Show did say something. Number 11, Fallen Forever. Her best two were out the straight. Maybe that would have won if not stumbling out the gates on last, and was way off the pace, but came on to get within 4 and 4th, and was three-quarter length behind number 12 here. It's a beautiful day. Good chance tomorrow, this one. As you know, she has been down in the scales for this run, and Apprentice Roger Hewitt could ensure a good ride. Blinkers is on, and the cheek piece is off. This is the first time Blinkers will be on. She has already run 3 times in visor. Number 12, It's a Beautiful Day. Had support in last 2 starts and up with the leaders in both, but flattened approaching the winning post. Blinkers off. First time figure eight is on. And Dave Nelson, he stays. Number 11, Fallen Forever. Number 2, Dream of Mine. Number 8, Uncle Bally. Number 1, Get Storm. Number 12, It's a Beautiful Day. Race 8. This race is named in honor of Tudorwit, 1975 Derby winner. Emilio Rodriguez was the rider. Melvin Parkstone Stables, the owner. Sidney Watson, the trainer. I remember this race vividly. Tudorwit, at that time, was just about to leave Jamaica College, and Rodriguez was my favorite jockey. Anyway, 12 starters, 4 furlong straight or 800 meters straight. Number 1 also correct. Seems off color, and even though getting back her blinkers and likened to run fresh as well, we'll be facing her easiest task for quite a while, but for her to win, I can't see that. Number 2, Awesome Cat. That win on the round course says a lot on her physicality. Number 5, Mark of a Prince, won easily against Similar, and with this rider board says much. It's coming off a 2.5 month respite and adores running off the bench. Will have to be caught. Number 8, Clearly Owls. 10-year-old mare, fairly consistent campaigner, who is another coming off the bench, and another who loves it that way. Could find a few younger ones too competitive to allow her for a top 3 slot here. Number 9, Cat Frigga, just can't follow through with his run. This shortened distance and course could be the answer, as he is very light. Number 10, Line of Judah, never been this light. Let's see how he does for this new trainer who recently claimed him. Number 11, Mount Zion King, Fit Galdin, who goes back to his favorite course, of which he won, beating a few that were in this race, that are in this race on September 19th. Shane Ellis, he gets the call with 57 kilos and well drawn. Number 12, Project, well drawn for a trainer Ryan Darby, who seems to get anything to run well. Number 5, Mark of a Prince. Number 9, Cat Rigger. Number 11, Mount Zion King. Number 2, Awesome Cat. Number 10, Line of Judah. We go to race 7. It's named in honor of the 1995 Derby winner, Dorval. Dorval was ridden by Neville Anderson. Richard Azan was the owner as well as the trainer. For Trailing Up, it's an optional claiming race, 200 to 250,000. With 5-year-olds, was never won 2 races, as well as 6-year-olds, was never won 4 races in their career. 14 starters, 7 furlongs, or 1400 meters. Number 1, Party Princess, was victorious 3 weeks ago. A round before that was over tomorrow's distance of 7 furlongs, and it was okay. Finishing 4th, Treedance to Stalwart and Girl First Selection, who is here again, and Reassurance. Will face a few seasoned horses in this class, but her fitness could have her in the lower order of your top 5. Number 4, General Umurak, same I can say about this one. Fit Galen, the Nelson stays, and could be a factor in your lower exotic. Number 5, Kunuma, has been looking responsive at exercise. Don't try this one to win, but another who can be tucked in your lower segment of your high 5. Number 6, El Cliente, back to his happy hunting ground with the apprentice who was on for that easy win on September 19th. Down a notch in claim, obviously because of the escalated purse money, and El Cliente for Stephen Todd is the horse to beat here. Number 12, Unbreakable, has more to find off that last run at this tag, especially returning to the unsaddened enclosure looking uncomfortable. However, was the leader up to the 1.5 furlong point from the winning post, and that was a two-turn distance, and could be much too much for Unbreakable at this point in time of his career. Back to an approximate trip he adores. So, Unbreakable with Robert Halladine could be looked at. Number 8, Subby, was trained for this race, I'm sure, due to the escalated purse, as I should remind fans that you have to take that in consideration. You have some horses that will be dropping down a notch to compete for the added purse money. This horse, Subby, has back class, and his trainer does remarkable with these type. And as I said, he drops a notch. Subby, nice handicap. Another say surely. Number 11, Day Commander, unreliable, but trainer Alfred Brown is doing well, and Armageddon was a recent claim and a recent example. He has gotten the leading rider, Anthony Thomas, interest to ride this one. So, number 12, First Selections, gets the Cardenas. Number 14, Smashing One, could be considered for a minor placing. Number 8, Subby. Number 11, Bay Commander. Number 6, El Cliente. Top 3 here. Especially number 6, El Cliente. Number 1, Party Princess. Number 14, Smashing One, should or could fill the lower order. Race 8. It's named in honor of the 1985 Derby winner, Diesel Legend. Ridden by Andrew Andreed. Owned by Dennis Howell and Steve Bryan. Kenneth Mattis, the trainer. 6.5 furlongs or 1300 meters, 13 starters for neighborhood fivers and up, who've never won 3 races in their career. This race gave me an ache when I was preparing to analyze. Hey, almost all horses here do their exercise in the equine pool as well as going to the sea. So I can't visualize them to give a more accurate opinion anyway. Number 2, Cora, had an easy victory against a number of horses in this race at this exact trip on August 29th. She seems to like this distance. Number three, it's in favor, capable for a minor middle order finish in the top five. Number four, She Says Yes, looking in very good condition this week, but normally breaks slowly out the gate. Has the master, Shane Ellis, to ride, and he will get the best out of her, seeing that her two career wins, Shane Ellis was the pilot. Number five, My Mom Just, ran from way off to be four and a half lengths behind Party Princess. That was her best display in ages. So chances are My Mom Just, Trainer Ian Alexander, has found out more about this mare, and she's poised to run a good race. Number seven, Trickster, really looked very good October the 27th, strolling out the straight, 5 furlong straight. I tell you, it really was laying out a lot. Let's see what tricks they will do come tomorrow. Number 10, Sacrifice, may play a part somewhere in your exotic placing. Number 11, Strike Clean Gorgeous, likely to be the leader, but at 6.5 furlongs could fall apart, reaching the furlong point. Number 12, Luminous Power, his consistency makes him the standout horse here. Number 13, Instagram, kind of like how he's looking at exercise. Number 12, though, Luminous Power, but several have a chance to win if Luminous Power fails, including number 4, She Says Yes, number 2, Cora, number 5, My Mom Just, number 7, Trickster, based off that exercise gallop I saw on the 27th. Okay, we are at the penultimate race, and the great race, the Jamaica Derby, the dream race for every horse owner all over the world. Very prestigious. A huge purse, $6.5 million. This race is named in honor of Sir John Mordecai, the first ever Jamaica Racing Commission chairman. Sir John was very liked, very approachable, and well respected by all. You can go check the replay on the Open Gate Show Facebook as well as YouTube for more detailed analyzation of the starters here. But number 1, Money Monster, born the 21st of March, a big gelding by Casual Chick, although she's traditional by traditional, bred, owned and trained by Fitzroy Grisby, groomed by Leroy Byfield, Orlando Foster will ride. Working well, looking well. If the top one fails, he could be the one. Hey, he's one of three horses to win going two turns. If one of a kind, and Nipster fails, well, as a matter of fact, one of a kind and Nipster are the only two other horses who won going two turns. Number 2, Chimpanza, born the 11th to 12th of June at Grace Philly, by American Dance, out of Beware Baby, by Friendly Lover. Bred by Ham Stables Limited, owner Naya. Groom, Riverton Nelson, the Cardinals will ride for trainer Richard Zan. We have some support. She has a trainer who knows how to prepare horses going this distance. This June bred filly has the genes to get this trip, but may lack the class at present. Number 3, Double Crown, born the 24th of April at Chestnut Gelding, by Bellamy Road, out of Salty Talk, by Midshipman. Breeder, Ian Sean Christopher Passard, owner PJK Team. Groom, Dunstan Bramwell, the jockey Dane Dawkins, for trainer Ian Passard. Has some astute horsemen on a high after her first two career starts with those two easy wins. He's bred and conformed to get as far as they can run. He looks focused and sharp and has already ran well enough against the top three-year-old at this distance of ground. Yes, he has more scope to improve than all here. Is fresh and could get on the board. And another that I think, if things doesn't work as it seems, could upset. Number 4, Another Affair, born the 21st of March, Chestnut Philly, by Nuclear Wayne, out of Commander Affair, by Black Bear Affair. Breeder Michael Bernard, owner Micros, Jerome Innes, will ride for trainer Gary Sobrati. Claude Tom is the groom of this horse. One of four horses here to run well beyond 9 furlong and 25 yards. The others are Nipster, Wow Wow, and One of a Kind in the St. Ledger. Rick should be rated better for securing a top three spot, which would be the owner's dream to be the first owner maybe in the world in a derby to run first, second, and third. Number 5, Nipster, born the 25th of April. A Bay Colt by Casual Trick out of Nippet by Legal Process. Breeder Michael Bernard, owner Micros, Linton Stedman, ride for Gary Sobrati, the groom Michael Campbell. What can I say about this colt but to highlight its stamina and improvement as well as his style of running that he displayed in the St. Ledger for that win. He is definitely one of the top two in here. Number 6, One of a Kind, born the 24th of April, Chestnut Colt by Fearless Vigil out of the Golden One by Royal Minister. Breeder, Orange Valley Estates Limited, owner Joseph Loares, groom Ian Winter. Lane Nelson gets the call for trainer, the champion trainer Anthony Nunes. 6 career starts, starting in June of this year. Ran well enough when facing winner Nipster on both occasions around 2 turns. The last 2 were in September. Has lots of support for winning expectations tomorrow. He has to improve if he expects to win the coveted Derby event. Has he improved enough? Maybe not. But how much to be afforded a winning chance? This won't be the same race as in the St. Ledger, where Mahogany surprise display caused confusion among 12 top contenders then. On paper, he can win. But I may be one of a kind to say he's not likely to impact on his recent conquerors in the St. Ledger that just ran over a month ago. I am not Moses, nor an egotist. We all have an opinion, and I'm sure you will agree to respect same. Number 7, Wow Wow, born the 28th of February, a Bay Colt by Casual Chick out of Sierra Barracuda by Prize, breeder Michael Bernard, owner Micros, groom Errol Thomas, Robert Halladine rides for Gary Sobrati. They have 3 strong entry in this race. Wow Wow, the class in this field, has raced more than all 14 times with 11 wins and 2 second place finishes. The question asked by all is if he stays well. He was in front of all except stablemate Nipster at the winning post. Different distance where two more furlongs are added, but it will be a different race also, as it will likely that the mahogany factor won't be on Wawa's connections mindset. So no premature move should be made. One thing that is being ignored, no horse in this race can be regarded as a surety to get this 12 furlong distance, except for number 5 Nipster. If Wow Wow can relax near enough to the pace and gradually increase towards who is in front, and I emphasize gradually, from 2.5 furlongs out, he could use his class to take the Derby Gallon for the winner. Any quick move will expel needed energy, but who am I to be saying this? But let's see what happens. Number 8, Mahogany, born the 27th of February, a chestnut gelding by Sensational Slam, out of Meteorite by Traditional, a breeder, Clovis George Metcalf, CD and OD, owner P. Ellis, H. Pratt, T. Pragnell, and Karen Passard. Ian Passard trains Omar Walker, will be riding. That win going 8.5 furlongs on August 16th was really spectacular. Next, he experienced 2 turns for the first time, and that was in the St. Ledger, where he ran no race at all, in my opinion, considering all his previous performances. if it, he doesn't like to be eyeballed, or would be more suited to the visor than the blinkers. If it, he ain't well or has trained off. Is it? So many questions on this one. Team Passard knows what it takes to win races, and the Open Gate Show wishes all big investors in our beloved sport all the best. Regrettably though, I'm a bit iffy on this one tomorrow, but hope I'm wrong and Mahogany come with a very good display. He looked his old self this morning, and the first for quite a while I've seen him looking so sharp, this Mahogany. Number 9, King Arthur, born the 1st of March. Big gelding by natural selection, out of Geisha's Heart by Pat and Jack. Groom, Leon Walker. Breeder, Glenn Leith Robinson. Owner, Carlton Watson. Wayne DaCosta, OD, trains. Philip Parchment will ride. Has a lot to find, but if he can close from off the pace, maybe it's likely he could pass some tiring ones for a small share of the lesser slice of the Derby cake. Number stablemate. No, we haven't reached to the stablemate yet. We have Green Gold Rush first. Number 10, Green Gold Rush, born the 3rd of February, Big Gelden by Aurora Gold of Princess Lorna by Love to See. Owned and bred by Winston Tracy, groom Wayne Anderson, Junior Small, trains Shane Ellis, he gets the ride. Has a lot to find, even though getting his groove back, in my opinion, in how he carries himself at the exercise. Has the top rider in the land in Shane Ellis. That won't create a win, but whatever comes, I'm sure Green Gold Rush will get a good ride. Number 11, Fearless Champion, born the 25th of April. Roan Cold by Fearless Vision, out of Granville Greeter, out of He's the Real Link. Bred, YS 925 Limited, owner Carlton Watson. Groom, Guard Pennant. Trainer Wayne DaCosta, OD, has the leading rider and his go-to rider, Anthony Thomas, aboard. The only horse in the race that has never ventured around two turns in 9 career starts. And for that alone, it's a disadvantage. As well as, I'm not impressed how he looked on Tuesday, and even this morning I wasn't impressed either. Well, after all this race, history will be written. Each Derby contender connection has to accept the winner will take it all, and congratulations should be given in order to all. The Open Gate Show wishes all participants the best of luck. Top 7. Number 5, Nipster. Number 7, Wow Wow. It could go either way. If Wow Wow doesn't stay, then Nipster is going to win again. Number 3, Double Crown. For a third. Number 6, One of a Kind. Number 1, Money Monster. Number 8, Mahogany. Number 4, Another Affair. Okay, we go to the final race. Race 10 is for trios and up over that allowance race. 13 starters, 5.5 furlongs or 1100 meters. It is named in honor of Philip Michael Fiani O'D. He saddled 10 Derby winners. A gentleman, a patriot, a horseman, the maestro. He's inducted in the Guinness Book of World Records in 1992 with most classics wins. And he is one of the director at Hams Farm Limited. Okay, 13 starters. Number 1, Captain My Ship, surely captured attention when skipping away 3 weeks ago, going up in grade with a good win at this trip in a smart time of 105 flat, where Rich None Here ran even close to that 105 in their career for this distance. So that alone speaks volumes for him to make this 4 in a row for connections. Number 4, Formal Fashion, up in grade, but already ran against the top ones in this race, except for Capture My Ship, and did very well. Love this distance and it's very light this time, will be there, especially if Captain My Ship fails. Number 8, wartime is as game as they come and could gain an exotic spot. I must say, she always run well in the night pan. Remember that. Number 9, Ras Emmanuel, packs 57 kilos and even with Shane Ellis will find it difficult to win. He ran well in the past against the top sprinters in the land when they were sitting level weights with 57 kilos, especially in the super on the super stakes race there in that 6 furlongs Caribbean sprint. Could still chase the speed for a show on the board. Number 12, Harris Train, looking in fine fetter, but has been unreliable lately. Number 13, Enough is Enough. A grey coat that has been looking much sharper since that last race a month ago should impact for a top 2 finish. Top 3, number 4, Formal Fashion, number 1, Captain My Shift, number 13, Enough is Enough. This is the order of my preference. Number 4, Formal Fashion, number 13, Enough is Enough, number 1, Captain My Shift, number 9, Ras Emmanuel, number 8, War Time. My best 3, I've not been doing very well with my best 3, but here goes. Third race, number 7, KJ Express. Fifth race, number 11, Fallina Forever. And in the 10th race, number 4, Formal Fashion. All the best of luck. Join me tomorrow afternoon when I will analyze Sunday's race card. And, you know, it's a big day. Remember to keep your social distances. Sanitize your hands. Wear your mask. And don't cluster around. The time is here when it's the cooler era, and according to scientists, this is the time when the COVID issue can be much complicated. So ensure that you keep hydrated by drinking Jamaica's pure Pride bottled water. Pure water, a pure water we drink.